हेलो एवरीवन, टुडे आवर टॉपिक इज डाटा हैंडलिंग। नाउ क्वेश्चन अराइज, व्हाट इज अ डाटा? लेट मी एक्सप्लेन विद द हेल्प ऑफ एन एग्जांपल। हाउ टीचर मेंटेन रिकॉर्ड्स फॉर एनी क्लास टेस्ट? हाउ शी राइट मार्क्स अकॉर्डिंग रोल नंबर्स। सो सपोज रोल नंबर 1 गेट मार्क्स 5 out of 10, then roll number 2 gets 7, roll number 3, 8, roll number 4, 5, roll number 5, 6. So in this way, teacher will maintain record. How we have written marks of the students? In numerical figure. So this is known as data. So data means information in the form of numerical figure. Then how teachers write marks here? According to roll number, this marks is of roll number 1, then 7 is of roll number 2, then 8 is of roll number 3, then 5 is of roll number 4, then 6 is of roll number 5. So in this way, teacher maintain record. So according roll number wise, means this data is known as raw data. This data is known as raw data. So raw data means data obtained in the original form is called raw data. Then I am taking here another example. Given below is the data showing the number of children in 20 families of a colony. So in first family, number of children 2, then in second 1, then in third family 3, then in fourth 1. So in this way we are having here number of children in 20 families. So firstly, I am arranging this data in ascending order. So you can see here 1 comes 5 times. So firstly write 1 5 times, then 2 comes 7 times, then write 2 7 times, then 3 here comes 6 times, then 4 comes 2 times. So how I have written this data? I have written data here in the ascending order. So arranging the numerical figure in ascending order or in descending order is called an array. So arranging the numerical figure in ascending order or in descending order, that is called an array. So this is the array. So if you have to write data in ascending order or in descending order, then it is known as array. Now our next topic is observation. So how we have written here data in numerical figure? We have written here data in numerical figure. So each numerical figure in data is known as observation. Okay, so each numerical figure in a data is called an observation. Then if we will write data in a tabular form, so that is known as the tabulation of the data. Okay, then our next point is frequency. So what is the frequency of an observation? Now you can see here 1 comes 5 times, then 2 comes 7 times, then 3 comes 6 times, 4 comes 2 times. The number of times a particular observation occurs is known as frequency. Okay, so number of times a particular observation occurs is called its frequency. Now this is the frequency distribution table. In our observation, we are having here four numbers. So 1, 2, 3, and 4. So this we will write in the column of observation. Then for frequency distribution table, we will make second column of telemarks, then third column of frequency. So you know, 1 we are having 5 times, so 1 we will write in observation column. Then for telemarks, because 1 repeat there 5 times, so for telemarks we will write 5. What is the telemarks? Firstly, I will explain this. Telemarks means symbolic pattern of the numbers, numerical figures. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and for writing fifth number we will cross it. So this is equals to 5. So this is the symbolic pattern of writing numerical figure. This is known as telemarks. Then why we will use telemarks? Because if we will write a large number in this way, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, then quickly we cannot tell how many numbers it is. That's why we will use telemarks, because 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So we know here we are having two sets of fives. Okay, then 5, 5, 10, 11, 12. So quickly we can give answer if we are having this pattern. Okay, then so 1 we are having here 5 times. So we will write 1, then we will put telemarks 5 for standing line, then 5th we will cross it. Then in frequency we will write 5. Then 2 we are having here 7 times, then 2, and for 7 we will make telemarks 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Then in frequency column we will write 7. Then for 6 we will write set of 5 and 1. Okay, then 4 comes here 2 times, then we in frequency we will mark 2 vertical lines, and in frequency column we will write 2. So this is the frequency distribution table. If you have written data already in ascending order, then quickly you can put telemarks and you can tell their frequency. But if you will not arrange data in ascending order and you have to make frequency distribution table, then how will you make that? I will explain. Suppose you are having marks of any subjects of 5, 10 students. So suppose roll number 1 gets 5 marks, then 8, then 6, then 5, 5, 6, okay, then 5, 6, 8, then 5. So how will you maintain record for this? Okay, so first we will make columns, first for observation, then second for telemarks, then third for frequency. Okay, so we are having here our smallest number is 5, then 6, and then 8. Okay, then our first number is 5. So in front 5, put vertical line in telemarks column. Then second number is 8. So in front 8, put then 6. Then we are having 5. So in front 5, again we are having 5. Then 6. Again now we are having 5. Then 6. Then 8. Now we are having 5. Already we have written here 4 for the 5. Now we have to put for 5th times, so we will cross it. So now write with the help of telemarks frequency. 5 we are having 5 times, 6 we are having 3 times, then 8 we are having 2 times. So you can verify also your sum right or wrong. Count frequencies total. So 5 plus 3, 8, 8 plus 2, 10. We are having here 10 students marks. and frequencies total is also 10. So our frequency distribution table is correct. So this is the frequency distribution table.